Now, the first topic that we want to talk about is UTM tagging, and it's really the most important part of this module. Where does my traffic come from? And if you're familiar with Google Analytics, you would probably do this. You would probably first log into your Google Analytics account like this one, go into the acquisition report and click on channels or source medium, whatever works for you. And then you would see, oh, there are some people coming through Google, some through autoresponder, some through Facebook and direct. But the big question here is, how does Google actually decide how to put them into different groups here, how to group them together? They're grouped by source and medium. And we have the channel grouping that we can make use of, which we already did. This is on the processing side. Something comes in and then we put it into the right channel. With source medium, it works a little bit different. Google actually looks at the information that it can get from the user where the user just came from. So for example, when he clicked through on google.com on a search result, he will enter the site with a referrer of google.com, and Google will take that referrer and put it into the right source and medium, Google Organic. That holds true for many different channels like Google CPC, which is basically AdWords, or Facebook. But what if there is no referrer information attached? Well, it will go into one channel that is sometimes too big of a channel, which is direct none. Now, direct none is not a problem. A lot of people say, oh, people enter through the homepage all the time. They know my brand. This is growing. This is great. But is this really the case? And if the traffic is a substantial part of your whole marketing plan, the direct none channel, then this is really that traffic, because you don't know where the traffic came from, what the intention of the user was, and you can't really scale that traffic. And just an example here with direct none, if I put in the secondary dimension landing page, then I see that a lot of people came through this blog post here or this website, and they landed directly on this and came through the channel direct none. Wouldn't that go against the belief that people typed it in directly? No, there needs to be a different reason for that. And this is where UTM tracking kicks in. You've probably seen these website URLs appear where there's a long tail at the end of it and it says UTM medium, UTM source, and UTM campaign. And these are UTM parameters, and they signalize to Google Analytics, please put them into the medium source category of email and source newsletter. And we can even filter down by campaign or put in more of these parameters to segment down deeper into our data. And all these data points will be available in the reporting later. And that way we'll be able to show Google Analytics that we want this data point, this page view, put into the right source medium category. And there are basically five parameters here that you can use. There's UTM medium, source, campaign, content, and term. And they're super useful for campaigns that you run where you really want to know where is this traffic coming from and maybe even what did people click on. So for example, if you have a banner campaign running, a retargeting campaign, you could choose the medium display, the source retargeting, the campaign ad roll or AdWords or any other vendor out there, the content maybe rectangle banner, and the term Christmas promotion. So you can later see exactly who clicked on that link with these UTM parameters and connect it to the outcome, which is maybe a sale. So these UTM parameters are super crucial for sources where Google Analytics can't identify the referrer. Now, when is that the case? For example, with an email campaign. Let's say you have send out a newsletter, people open it up in Outlook and click on the link, and then it opens up a browser window and your website appears. Now, Google Analytics wouldn't know that you just clicked on that link. It would appear as a direct none because no referrer information is attached to that, because you didn't come from another website. you actually came from another program, which is Outlook, which obviously Google Analytics can't read and won't have information in the HTTP referrer. So it's very, very crucial. Biggest mistake I see with analytics accounts that obvious traffic, like the email traffic, is not tagged correctly. So it's super crucial to build this into your links that you give other vendors, that you put somewhere to drive traffic to your page. If you have control over this link, then put in UTM parameters to exactly know where people came from and what did they click on. And you don't have to type this always by yourself. There are automation tools out there, such as the UTM URL builder or a Google Sheet by Lunametrics. Let's take a look. So this URL builder is built by Google and you can find it in the help section, and it will help you to streamline your process in putting UTM tags onto your email campaigns, for example. So let's put this in here. Our website is demo shop. The campaign source would be autoresponder. And the medium would be email. And the campaign name would be just the April newsletter. So we have here April. And then you can submit it. Be aware that you need to have a source, a medium, and a name in your UTM tags, a campaign name in your UTM tags. That's very important because otherwise you will get this not set within Google Analytics, and Google Analytics might not interpret your UTM tags correctly. So you need to have a source, medium, and campaign name. And the other ones obviously optional: campaign term and content. So once you click on submit, you get the fully tagged link that you can copy and paste into your email campaign. Now, if you work with Google Analytics a little bit longer, you know that it's super crucial how you tag these links, because you want to be able to later drill down only by the campaigns, for example, that came through autoresponder or that was sent out in April. So you need to have a little bit of a methodology of tagging the links if you do tag a lot of links. And this URL builder is probably fine for one link that you send out, but if you have a real campaign running with maybe 10 or 20 links, you need to keep a close eye on what the methodology is where you tag the links. And there's where a handy sheet comes in, a Google Sheet here by Lunametrics. And what this can do is it can give you the link at the end in a spreadsheet row, and you can put in, for example, the source, medium, and campaign here, here the actual landing page, and in the end you get these links that you can just copy. In order to use this, I have the link in the resource sheet. You can go to file and then make a copy. So we'll actually copy this sheet, then it's your own, and then you can go ahead and start tagging your page. And here you can put in the required fields, such as autoresponder, email, and campaign. And you can use the functions that Google Sheets has built in, so you could copy this down, and even the actual landing page. I would say, okay, we always have this email, but the months change. So in the end, we get these links that we can copy right into our email software, and they're all tagged correctly. Please notice that I use to always keep this in non-capitalized letters, because Google Analytics actually distinguishes between that. So if I put in July here, this would be another campaign that would be tracked. So try to keep it in small letters. So this is really a handy tool for doing any kind of UTM tagging. If you set up an autoresponder or an email campaign for your client, then be sure to include UTM parameters. A lot of email providers nowadays, such as MailChimp or GetResponse, they have this functionality already built in to tag your links automatically, so I would take advantage of that. But that, if that's not the case, be sure to tag all your links.